Then when's the last time you heard a message where the guy teaching was describing God as darkness and gloom and a tempest? Yet this is the word of God. It's terrifying, isn't it? The thought of coming, he's making reference to the Exodus when he put darkness over the land. And the storms, the hailstorms where people would die. He goes, man, you understand who you're coming before. This isn't just another person. Man, but he's a blazing fire and darkness all at once and gloom and a tempest. This is crazy. This is who we are coming before. Man, you gotta understand something. This is great news. Okay, now I know people say, wait, how could God being a blazing fire and darkness and gloom and a tempest be good news? Because the world twists everything. And they want to believe in a God that's soft and cuddly and would never harm anyone. You know, but you know why this is such great news? When I think, you know, because people go, gosh, you know, God can't tell me what to do. I have dreams, I have desires. I'm like, I'm pretty sure he can. I mean, you don't, he refers to himself as a tempest. And in Job, he answered him out of a whirlwind. Can you imagine standing in an opening field and seeing a tornado come at you? There's not a lot you can say, right? You can't look at that and go, I have dreams. This is the God that I come. You know why this is great news? Is because if this God is for me, are you kidding me? That is for me. Man, who could be against? That's great news.